Hello and welcome to another Ambition Market Knowledge video. And today I'm delighted to talk with Simon Tobin, who's Managing Director of Ambition Finance. Simon, what's happening in the accounting and finance market at the moment?
Well, Paul, it's a good question against the backdrop of so many bad news stories and negative messages that we get when we look at our popular media and listen to our politicians. And I tend to think that if a person from Spain or Greece read our papers, listened to our politicians, got those messages, they'd wonder what we were all whinging about. Is it as bad as all that? Well, yes and no. There are aspects of the market that are feeling some pain. And in finance and accounting, there's definitely been a drop in demand over the last year. Advertising for finance roles has dropped about 15% in New South Wales. However, macro level, unemployment's still fairly full, and most people who want roles are in roles. So what we have is a very static market where there's not much candidate liquidity and there's not a lot of movement.
What's happening to salaries at the moment? Are they rising or falling?
Look, they're static as well, and there isn't that lack of growth hiring. We're just seeing critical replacement hiring, like-for-like replacements, and not a lot of growth, which means salary uplifts when moving from role to role are minimal, and it's a fairly static market. Variable components of salaries, so bonuses and other sorts of incentives, are generally low to or zero to low, really. And we're seeing movements year on year of base salary reviews in the low single digits.
Right. And when I'm talking to people, the common feedback seems to be that we're working more hours. And is that actually the case?
I think it is. I mean, there's a couple of components to that. Firstly, there is much more connectivity these days between work and home and other places where the technology in the past has been an enabler, from BlackBerries to laptops to other methods of keeping in touch with the office and working from home. Now I'm hearing technology referred to as an enslaver, in that the line between work and home is blurring, and it means we're engaged with work much more often than we were in the past at different levels. So yes, we're working harder in the office as restructures and reductions of staff put pressure on back offices. We're more connected. And on a third level, anecdotally, people are trying to be more visible in the office to make sure that they're seen as critical, as busy, as important, and to keep keep on the radar of their bosses.
Yeah. And is morale falling within organisations?
Very tricky one, morale. It's difficult to define, difficult to measure. Who's responsible for it? Whose fault is it? I would say that where organisations have gone about, say, a restructure, downsize, outsource, offshore, as a cost control measure, the right way, where communication is good and there's been a sensible enterprise-wide project to address those sorts of efficiency measures, then there's been some protection around morale. And 26% of respondents to our survey have been in an organisation that's done one of those things. The wrong way to do that is say, we need some cost efficiency, we'll cut 10 or 15% of heads and everyone else will just have to soak it up. That's when morale is damaged and when employers start to become disaffected and disengaged. And I think in general there are, a proportion of employees who are finding it harder to connect with their organisation's mission and purpose and values and the communication and strategy and all those sorts of things. There is a smaller proportion or a significant proportion becoming a bit disaffected.
Right. And getting a crystal ball out for the next 6 months or so, we're talking in August 2012. What's going to happen between now and Christmas and early next year?
Last time I predicted a royal pregnancy, I was wrong. I'll just predict it again because I've got to be right eventually. But down in the employment market for the next 6 months, look, I think much the same. We have a static employment market where liquidity of candidates is limited. Job seekers are very conservative about making a move and employers are conservative about hiring, which just means, and while there's no growth hiring, that just means there's not a lot of churn. We'll see salaries and bonuses remain fairly flat. We'll see a continuing drive for efficiencies in terms of systems improvement, cost reduction, potentially offshoring of roles. That will lead to some demands for people and expertise in systems improvements, but also maybe put some jobs at risk. I also get the sense, though, a lot of organisations have done a lot of the people correction stuff, done a fair bit of the systems stuff. There's not a lot of flex left in the system. So when growth hiring starts again, as it certainly will at some point, maybe it's not 6 months, maybe it's 12 or 8 months or whatever, there will be quite a bit of churn. There's not a lot of people sitting on the bench waiting to be taken up. There's a proportion of disaffected people who are ready to make a move, and I anticipate a spike in churn when that growth hiring pattern starts again.
The big question is when, of course.
Indeed.
Thank you very much, Simon, for your comments today. If you have any questions or comments or feedback regarding market knowledge and your particular circumstance and your particular firm's circumstance, don't hesitate to give Simon or myself a call. Thank you.
Thank you, Paul.